A very good morning to you. Welcome to our 7 AM Mass Life News. In our highlights, Miss Flower Price increase. Student hustle at Kenya Institute of Mass Communication. Katisa Games in Mombasa. Welcome, my name is Mwenda Thairu. On to our news today, prices of maize flour has increased from 85 shillings to 90 shillings. The National Cereals Board says this is due to the current shortage. I took a walk in Isili earlier on and this is what I gathered.
The price of maize flour have increased by about 5 shillings for the 2 kilograms packet. A 2 kilogram packet of flour that retained at 85 shillings is now selling at 90 Kenya shillings. Some of the customers opt for flour from local portion mill where they take their maize grains for grinding. Mass TV, I'm Mwenda Thairu.
South B residents have been experiencing poor shortage drainage leading to low income in their businesses, hence spending much more in hospital bills for treatment. Our reporter Han Kifwi has more details.
We are bitter. Our city council is not doing us any good. This has been the cry of South B residents due to poor drainage system all over. They say it has really brought a lot of inconveniences, most especially during the rainy seasons.
Mimi naitwa Michael Mugo, na mimi ni kaaji wa hapa kwa Mkokoteni. Na hii drainage inatuudhi sana kwa sababu wakati mvua imenyesha inatokaka kwa barabara, hata wadudu wanakuja mpaka huku tunakanyaga wadudu. Sasa hii serikali watoe watu wao wa kufagia mitaro kwa barabara, kama ni waidhira kanzora wetu atuambie sisi wenye hapa tunajikorogea na tulipa mshahara.
Nayo city council ya hii town inawasaidia aje kuhusu drainage system?
Sioni faida ya city council. Lakini kwa majina naitwa Simon Moleithi. Lakini sioni faida. Wanaajiri watu, wanapea watu kandarasi lakini bure. Hata ukijiangalia wewe mwenyewe unaona. Hata sasa ukiangalia hata ndio kalabati zimevugika. Hii sikali kutikali yetu naona. Hakuna haja. Hakuna haja hiyo makazo na nini na nini. Tutufanya kazi sisi wenyewe. Kuliko tukaga hapa, mwagawaji wa nini nini. Mwajiri watu, kazi yao ni kuenda kukula pesa na kulala.
The lives of the residents at South B has been faced with many challenges due to poor water drainage system around the area. Reporting for KIMC TV, my name is Anne Kefwe.
Nairobi residents have been experiencing shortage of water in the past 1 month. This has made their livelihood expensive. Water vendors have been selling water at 30 shillings per jerrycan. I visited South B Mukuru Panjenga earlier on where I talked to some of the residents.
Water is life and one cannot live without water. Nairobi residents have experienced shortage of water for more than a month now. They say water comes once per week and to fetch it one must have a coin in the pocket to buy 120 liters at 10 shillings.
Okay, tunataka kuangalia maji imeadhiri sana watu wetu wa South B hapa. Habari yako mkubwa?
Mzuri sana.
Unaitwa nani?
Mimi naitwa Michael Mugo.
Michael Mugo. Maji huku inaonekana hakuna maji mingi huku, maji sana
hakuna. Maji inachotwa na Mkokoteni, si maji safi. Hii sisi hata tunanunuaga kwa duka ya kunywa.
Maji ya kunywa mnanunuaga kwa duka. Hakuna ile maji ile ya serikali, kuna mahali wameweka maji ama hakuna kitu kama hiyo?
Hakuna kitu kama hiyo, tunaichota na Mkokoteni.
Okay. Na mnachota maji wapi aswa?
Tunachota pale chini. Tukisambaza huku kwa manyumba.
Na mtungi mmoja mnauzia watu pesa ngapi?
Tunauzia 30.
Mtungi mmoja.
Eh.
Na watu wananunua maji kwa wingi ama bando wako huko huko tu kwa ile maji yao ya?
Wananunua kwa wingi kwa sababu kwa manyumba zao hakuna.
Okay. Na serikali imejaribu kusaidia kazi hii kuonekana maji imepatikana huko?
Maji haijapatikana.
Mwende Thairu, Mass TV.
We have more news in store for you after the short break. Don't go away.
Thank you.
where they have been practicing for the competition. On to business news. Students have been trying to make ends meet as young entrepreneurs. Our reporter Pauline visited Kenya Institute of Mass Communication, where she found students engaging in different business activities. Let's hear more from our reporter.
Students at Kenya Institute of Mass Communication have embraced entrepreneurship alongside studies. In our interview with some of the students having businesses, they admit there is high competition in the media industry, leading to lack of jobs.
Best market for now that I'm a student is at the female hostels at KIMC or any other hostels outside, because I can't go, it's very expensive even for me to go and open a shop, start selling them. But again, I can't hawk, I can't be a hawker. I also have classes, so I sell them at my free time. That's when I go around, sell them. And I also prefer approaching my customers. It's very hard for a lady to come ask, are you selling pants? Yeah, it's not always very comfortable. So I always prefer approaching them.
So the market is friendly to you?
At school, very much friendly.
Hence, students resort to business and job creation, with quite a number starting businesses to make a living.
Tuambie kuhusu biashara yako ya viatu.
Nauzanga viatu Kenya Mass. Juu market iko juu pia. Wasichana wananunua haraka haraka. Nauza sana sana za wasichana, siuzi za vijana.
Unazitoa wapi?
Nazitoanga Gikomba. Naamka asubuhi by 6 nikuwe huko. Nakuja each and nachukua each and every Monday na Sunday. Alafu nakuja nauza.
Nakupea faida.
Inanipea faida, lakini bei inalingana kwa sababu viatu zingine kama hii ya white. Hii ni bei ghali sana. Unaona hii ni kiatu yenyewe iko na material nzuri. Si kama ile ni ya bit cheaper kidogo inategemea.
Pauline Joroge reporting for Mass TV.
And to our sport news, KMC places great importance in curriculum activities. Basketball is one of the games played. Great changes have been done to improve their performances. A new pitch has been renovated, which makes student practice better. Cecilia has more details on that.
KMC places great importance in co-curriculum activities, and the institute considers it part and parcel of the training. Basketball being one of the games students enjoy playing has given them a chance to showcase their talents. Langina reporting from KIMC.
Several universities and colleges are practicing for the Ketisa Games, which will be held in Mombasa County this December holiday. Our reporter Phyllis has visited KIMC.
Universities and colleges are busy preparing for the end of year Kenya Technical Institution Sports Association Ketisa Games to be held in Mombasa next month. The Kenya Institute of Mass Communication KIMC will be participating in basketball, volleyball, hockey and football games. Students are currently practicing to perfect their skills. Having attained their best position in the last Ketisa Games, they hope to perform better this season.
I'm Phyllis Maina reporting from KIMC.
We have come to the head of the 7 a.m. news. We'll be having more at 11 a.m. I have been your host, Mwenda Thaidu. Goodbye.